construction materials all over the place, but just ignore that.
Something else?
Yeah, a shed right here. Yeah. I'm getting a tractor to put in it, and I'm so excited. So I bought this property about 23 years ago, and then I bought it for the stream, and you'll see the stream. It was just such a beautiful spot. So to get to the treehouse, you walk across my yard. So I'll find like little interesting pieces at yard sales and things. So I'll like use them. Like I found these for candles for the path down. And this was kind of like a cool, so I'll just kind of like put little tidbits along the path just to make it a little more special and interesting. And then brings you down to the treehouse. So we're at Stone City Treehouse in Hardwick, Vermont. I've lived here for about 20 years and built the treehouse about 3 years ago. Completed it 3 years ago. And so Hardwick is in the southwest corner of the Northeast Kingdom of Vermont. And it's a great little town, great community, and it's been a great spot to host my guests here at the treehouse. So for many years I've had like a little campfire down here. Then I built the first thing I think I built actually was this little platform for sitting and having the campfire. There is electricity clearly, and so I have a power line running back here. I don't have any, there's no running water. So that created, you know, that creates more the glamping vibe, I think. So there's like a, you'll see inside there's like a water container that goes through into another container. And then there's a composting toilet. So, and I've had a lot of people be like, I'm not sure about the composting toilet, but then in the end they're like, it's totally fine. Yeah, yeah. So this I added last year, this hanging bed, and then I kind of like spruced it up this year. probably a good access areas here. So there's like this beautiful like swinging day bed. I've actually slept down here before, and it's such a nice place to sleep. It's hanging here. Yeah, so last year actually I added more insulation and like put these boards up. My son helped me with these boards. Yeah, another thing, just, you know, it's too much by yourself. I could show you the outdoor shower. Do you want to look at that? I mean, it's not anything like fancy. It's definitely very rustic. Yeah, it's been pretty great actually. So there's a hose. Well, originally I used some old maple sugaring line, and I'm not a plumber. So it's like, and I've set this all up so it like kind of sprays when it's being used. But that's okay. So you have to turn up on the water up at the house. The tub, I've taken some tubs out here and the shower out here. It's just, it's really nice. Yeah, it's really relaxing. There's like a little propane tank under here. I use like a old fish tank. And this actually came out of our Volkswagen. We have a Volkswagen Vanagon. And it was like the curtains from the Vanagon. I try to like reuse stuff as much as I can, and like the burlap and like an old wheel. So it's a pretty simple setup, really. But like, yeah, I built, well, not the stairs, but all the little details here and put in the railing. And then this door I found at a yard sale too. $10 for that door with the hardware too. So come on in. Welcome. So it's a small space, but it works well for two people. I try not to have more than two. Sometimes there's been three, but it's definitely a space that works. Yeah, so I built pretty much everything here. The cabinets, you know, there's just I'll turn the light on there. That might help. So there's like a little toaster oven and basic kitchen utensils, you know, couple plates, some silverware, pots and pans. I built this sink last year too. Last year was really productive. And yeah, there's like a little cook camp stove and a mini fridge. I mean, pretty much, you know, a couple different options for coffee. Yeah, these windows came out of an old schoolhouse in East Hardwick. A friend of mine had them and he gave them to me. You know, I'll see things around that seem to, like, you know, enhance the space, and so I'll pick things up here and there. So this is another area that I keep adding to, like, bits and pieces. Like, I think actually one of my guests was like, you should put lights up those trees. I'm like, that's a great idea. So definitely it's been a collaborative effort. You know, some of my guests will just have these wonderful ideas, and it is, yeah. It was an essential feature for sure. And so, you know, the sleeping loft is right there, and there's the window that opens up, and so you can, you know, listen to the stream while you're sleeping. It's been a fun process. And it's just like a nice relaxing space to come out to. So this is the little composting toilet, and in the right side you open it up and there's shavings. And then on the left side is the toilet. So, and then I have a friend who's like made me a few things for the treehouse, like this little stool. She'll just like surprise me and be like, I made you a stool for the treehouse. So that's great. And then she made that like piece of art there. Yeah, so she made that when I first opened it up. It's just nice. It's like a collaborative thing. It's nice to have like little pieces of people, and you probably saw like the wall here with all the pictures and the comments, and yeah, it's fun. The biggest inspiration was to make more use of this space, and also to just share it with people from around the world, to share that experience of nature and calmness and an appreciation for nature. So that, I guess, nature is my inspiration.